All right, guys, let's actually do some hypothesis testing now using Minitab. All right, so you know one of the things I try to beat in your head is why we do a particular test. So why we do confidence intervals versus why we do hypothesis testing. So why are we here? Why do we want to do hypothesis testing? Well, what happens is we have a claim about the population mean or the population proportion. So we have a claimed number for where the distribution is centered. Right, and we want to test if this claim is true or not. So we want to test whether or not the distribution really is centered at this value. So what do? Well, life's kind of on repeat here. We go get a sample. We calculate either the sample mean or sample proportion. And then we compare this statistic to the population parameter. And we do that using something called the p-value. All right, so how do we conduct a hypothesis test? I think the easiest way to kind of lay this out to you is to give you a recipe. Everybody can follow a recipe. So step one of the process, we're going to write the null and alternative and state the claim. Right? So every single time I do an example, you're going to see me do these. And on your quiz, the first question is going to be write the null and alternative and state the claim. All right, second, decide if the test is Z, T, or proportion. All right, well, obviously with proportion, we're dealing with qualitative data, we're reading a percent, so those are our clues for proportion. With Z, we know that we are either given the population standard deviation or the known standard deviation, and then T is kind of the catch-all for other, so when we're using data or we have a sample standard deviation. All right, and then we're going to use Minitab to calculate the p-value. We're going to compare the p-value to alpha and make a statistical decision. All right, so let's recall, how do we go about making the statistical decision? All right, well, if the p-value is less than alpha, we reject the null. And if the p-value is greater than alpha, we fail to reject the null. All right, so these are our only two decisions. Every single time you do a hypothesis test, you're going to have a decision of either reject the null or fail to reject the null. And then the last step is we want to write the conclusion in terms of the claim, okay? So how do we write the conclusion then? Well, we have two options. Either the null is the claim or the alternative is the claim, okay? If the null is the claim and we reject the null, then essentially we're rejecting the claim, right? And so that's what we say. There is enough evidence to reject the claim. And then we just want to actually say in the sentence what the claim is, which you'll see me do in a few examples in a few minutes. All right, if the null is the claim and we fail to reject the null, then now there is not enough evidence to reject the claim, right? So what happens if the alternative is the claim? How does the language change? Well, if the alternative is the claim and you reject the null, then you're kind of accepting the claim, you're supporting the claim. And so we say there is enough evidence to support the claim. If the alternative is the claim and you fail to reject the null, then there is not enough evidence to support the claim. And folks, this is something you need to know. I don't want to say you need to memorize it, is you just more need to know it. And I think that what's going to happen is I'm going to give you enough practice to where you just, your life goes on repeat, say, with one of these four conclusions. All right, so let's do some examples. All right, a consumer group claims that the mean annual coffee consumption by a person in the U.S. is 23.2 gallons. A random sample of 90 people in the U.S. has a mean annual coffee consumption of 21.6 gallons. Assume the population standard deviation is 4.8 gallons. At alpha equals 0.05, can you reject the claim? All right, let's step through this. Remember, we got a recipe. Step one, write the null and alternative. All right, so what do we read in the problem? We read that the mean annual coffee consumption is 23.2 gallons. So if we write that mathematically, we're writing mu equals 23.2. All right, because it is equals, it is the null. And because that's the one we're reading, it is the claim. Okay, so that's where we start. From there, we can write our alternative because our alternative is the opposite. And so the alternative would be mu is not equal to 23.2. All right, next question. Is this going to be z to your proportion? Hopefully you're thinking z because we read about the population standard deviation. All right, now we want to go to Minitab and actually calculate our p-value. All right, so let's get out of here. Move this over here and go over to Minitab. All right, so I'm in Minitab and we want to do a one sample Z is what we just said. All right, summarize data. We've got 90 in our sample. Our sample mean is 21.6. Our known standard deviation is 4.8. We want to perform a hypothesis test. The hypothesized mean is the claim. That's 23.2, all right? And then the final step is we need to go under options and specify our alternative hypothesis. And you'll notice here that the default is not equals to, which is what our alternative hypothesis is. So we say, okay. Minitab gives you the confidence interval results, all right, for a 95% confidence interval. We don't care so much about that, all right? Sometimes we're interested in, you know, what our sample mean is. We may be interested in how big our sample is. But what's of interest to us right now is the results of the hypothesis test down here. And of particular importance is the p-value. So we see a p-value of 0.0016. So let's take that back over to our PowerPoint here. All right, so we have a p-value of 0.0016, and we want to compare this to alpha. So how does it compare to 0.05? It is less than our alpha. Okay, so let's think back. Because the p-value is less than alpha, what are we going to do? We are going to reject the null. All right, so now we need to come up with our conclusion. So the null is the claim, and we are rejecting it. So, there is enough evidence to reject the claim that Americans consume, on average, 23.2 gallons of coffee. Right? Hopefully you're not thinking this is too difficult. Example 2. The Western blot assay is a blood test for the presence of HIV. It's been found that this test sometimes gives false positives for HIV. A medical researcher claims that the rate of false positives is 2%. A recent study of 300 randomly selected U.S. blood donors who do not have HIV found that 3% received a false positive test result. At alpha equals 0.05, can you reject the researcher's claim? All right, so we need to start with our null and alternative. What are we reading in the problem as the claim? And what we're reading in the problem is right here. A medical researcher claims that the rate of false positives is 2%. So we have the proportion. That's a rate, proportion. So we have rho equals 0.02, all right? Because it's equals, it is the null. Because we're reading it, it is the claim, all right? So we have rho equals 0.02. Now, what's our alternative going to be? Our alternative is the opposite, so it's rho not equal to 0.02. Now we need to decide, is this going to be z to your proportion? Well, clearly, because we're dealing with rho, this is going to be proportion. All right, so now we want to go over to Minitab and actually conduct the test. So we go over to Minitab, say one sample proportion. We have summarized data. All right, number of events, right? This is the number of people who have a false positive. So that was 3 in our sample out of 300. That's the number of trials. We want to perform a hypothesis test. The claimed proportion is 0.02. You do have to convert it to a decimal. All right, and we need to go under options and specify our alternative, which is not equal to, and change our method to normal approximation. Say OK. And we get this p-value of 0.2160. That is what we're going to take back over to PowerPoint with us to compare to alpha. So we're looking for this p-value. All right, so let's go back over to PowerPoint. All right, so how does 0.2303 compare to alpha 5%? It's clearly bigger than alpha. So if the p-value is bigger than alpha, what do? We fail to reject the null. So the null is the claim, and we fail to reject it. So we're not rejecting the claim. So there is not enough evidence to reject the claim that the rate of false positives is 2%. All right, let's do another example. A researcher claims that the mean cost of raising a child age 2 and under by families in rural areas is $11,060. In a random sample of families in rural areas, the mean annual cost of raising a child age 2 and under is $10,920. The sample consists of 800 children. Assume the population standard deviation is 1561. At alpha equals 1%, so notice alpha is different here, can you reject the claim? Well, again, what is the claim? What are we wanting to test in this problem? And so we go back to our first sentence here. A researcher claims that the mean cost of raising a child by families is $11,060. That's going to give us our null of mu equal to $11,060. All right, it is because it's equals, it is the null. Because we're reading it, it is the claim. The opposite for the alternative would be mu not equal to $11,060. Is this going to be ZT or proportion? And hopefully what you're saying is this is going to be Z because it says assume the population standard deviation is this amount. All right, so it's Z because we have the population standard deviation. Now we want to go over to Minitab and actually run their test to get our p-value. So let's escape out of here, go over to Minitab. We want to do a one sample Z, right, on summarized data. The sample size here was 800 children. The sample mean was 10,920. The known standard deviation is 1561. We want to perform a hypothesis test. And the claimed mean is 1160. All right. And then we need to go under options, specify our alternative, which is not equal to. And we can say OK. All right, here we get our p-value of 0.0112. So we're going to take 0.0112 back over to PowerPoint. We want to compare that to alpha. Now alpha here is 1%, so 1.12% is bigger than 1%. So our p-value is greater than alpha. What is our decision? It is to fail to reject the null. All right, so we are failing to reject the null. The null is the claim. We fail to reject it. So what's our conclusion? There is not enough evidence to reject the claim that the average cost of raising a child is $11,060. Right? Let's do another one. A Greenville City planner claims that the mean speed of traffic southbound along I-85 during morning peak hours is less than 50 miles per hour. In a random sample of 45 motor vehicles traveling southbound on I-85 during morning peak hours, the mean speed's 51 miles per hour. Assume the population standard deviation is 5 miles per hour. At alpha equals 0.05, is there enough evidence to support the city planner's claim? All right, what's the claim here? Let's go back to the beginning. What's the Greenville City planner claiming? That mean speed is less than 50 miles per hour. So now we start with the alternative that mu is less than 50. It is the alternative because it is a strict inequality, and it is the claim because we are reading it. The opposite will be our null, so the null is mu greater than or equal to 50. All right, is this going to be ZT or proportion? And again, hopefully you're saying this is going to be a Z test because we have the population standard deviation. All right, so now we want to go over to Minitab and actually run our test. So we go into one sample Z. We have summarized data. All right, we have 45 cars. Sample means 51. The known standard deviation is 5. We want to perform a hypothesis test. The hypothesized mean is 50. And we need to go under options and specify our alternative. Our alternative here is less than. Okay, so you can see over here the mu is less than. 50, we say okay. All right, and we get this very large p-value of 0.9101. So we take that back over to PowerPoint. All right, and 0.9101 is clearly bigger than alpha of 5%. And so when the p-value is bigger than alpha, what do? We fail to reject the null. So now let's think about our conclusion. The alternative is the claim, and we fail to reject the null. So now we will say there is not enough evidence to support the claim that the average speed on ID5 in the morning is less than 50 miles per hour. All right. And so with that, what I have done, let me show you. This is the one sample hypothesis testing classwork that's in Blackboard. And I have just gone through the first four problems. What I recommend you doing now is doing problems 5, 6, and 7. And there is a key on Blackboard. These will give you, you'll get another proportion problem, you'll get some T problems. So practice these before you go to the homework, all right, because I think these are a little bit easier with summarized data. All right, so what I would do, let's just go into Blackboard and take a look at this. Go into practice problems. I would finish here the one sample in class practice that I just showed you. From there, I would do the one sample classwork down here that has a little data file on it, as well as the key. So do that second. All right, and then last, come to the homework. The homework you will find the most challenging, and don't hesitate to text me or email me any questions you are having on this material.